First, select the object which should get data. Then select an object and make it active which should give data. Press CTRL+L or go to Object, Link Transfer Data and select the function which you want to use, for example, Link Materials. The Link Transfer Data function is a great way to transmit properties of an object to another one or more. You will find this function when you select Object in Object mode. Go to Object and there you find Link Transfer Data. The shortcut is CTRL+L. Then this menu pops up. I will only handle the first 10 functions and I will exclude the transfer function for this video tutorial. But let's jump into this topic now. Did you know that you can work with multiple scenes in one Blender file? Scenes are a way to organize your work. Each blend file can contain multiple scenes which share other data such as object and materials. For example, you can create one object and adjust it in one scene and place it for rendering in another scene. So this function works only when you have multiple scenes created. The Link Objects to Scene in the Adjust Last Operation panel lets you choose between scenes. This makes the same object exist in more than one scene at once, including its position and animation data. When you move the object in one scene, this will influence it in the other scene too. This linking is permanent. Links objects between scenes or data blocks of an active object to all selected objects. For example, you have two or more cubes and you want that the first cube will influence the others, then you have to select all and at least the main cube. CTRL+L, link object data. And you will immediately link the material from the first to all the others. This works as well when you edit the geometry. It doesn't work when you change the position, rotation or scale. It doesn't work either when you add a modifier to it. Funny is as well when you have a cylinder and an icosphere and you select both and link them, then the sphere becomes a cylinder. It will adopt the geometry. You may ask what you should do to break the linking. A solution can be enter the object data properties, then you see that there is a number beside the object data name. There is no number when there is no linking. By clicking on the number, you will make it a single user again and it will be not influenced anymore. Linking an already linked object with a new one will override the first link. But you don't need to link everything, probably you just want to link the materials of an object. Link materials will replace assigned object data materials. In this case, we have an object with a simple animation. Just select an object first, which should get the animation data. Then the object which contains the animation data and link them. Link animation data just copy and paste the animation behavior of an object. This is just a way to organize your collection management for the outliner. When you have an object in the specific collection and you want to add another object to this outliner, but probably you have already way too many objects in the scene, then this would be a nice option for you. This function replaces assigned collections. To be honest, I don't know how this works. I don't get it. I'm sorry guys, but here's the description. Replace assigned collection instance. Hope this helps. Replace text object font. I showed you in one of my previous videos how to change fonts. Link is in the description below. This link just take the modifier and its adjusted settings and place it to the selected objects. I think this would be useful for bevel modifiers or arrays, whatever. When you work with Crease Pencil and used any kind of modifiers here too, then you will be able to link those to selected Crease Pencil objects. The active UV map of object 2 will be replaced by a copy of the active UV map of object 1. If the selected object doesn't have any UV maps, then it is created. Objects must be of type mesh and must have a matching topology. So it wouldn't be possible if you try to copy UVs from the sphere to a cylinder. I guess this is logical. And that's all so far. Thank you very much for watching. It would be very nice to give this video a like and or subscribe to my YouTube channel for more game dev videos. Cheers!